Attorney General Githu Muigai has been on the receiving end from the technical working group which he appointed to look into the most appropriate formula to achieve affirmative action in Parliament for allegedly failing to forward their proposal to Parliament. But today, the government's chief legal advisor came out to dispel claims that the government is playing poker on the gender role.
So the Attorney General has to be guided as to the policy of the government by the cabinet. And this matter, as I have explained, is now with cabinet. The urgency of the matter has been brought to the attention of cabinet office, and we expect that there will be a very, very, very early hearing and resolution of the matter.
And as the cabinet readies to look into the proposals next week, Githu is advising against adopting a proposal that will raise the number of members of parliament as it would overburden the taxpayer.
What we would like to work with is a commitment to keep the numbers reasonable. So all we are saying is whatever methods we discuss, whatever methods we negotiate, we would like to be conscious that the size of the house must be kept reasonable, right?
Kenyans are concerned that they don't want additional burdens. But we've discovered that actually when we did, I'm sure you're there when we launched the report on the cost. And the cost is very minimal. It's only about 58 shillings per year to Kenyans. It's
per Kenyan?
More or less, yes, per Kenyan.
The proposal at the cabinet by the technical working group that was chaired by Wilfred Lichuma seeks to have affirmative action achieved through nominating members of the lesser gender in parliament through political parties, as it is done in the county assemblies.
The Attorney General, as an advisor to government and as the number one proponent of the implementation of the constitution, cannot purport that meeting the two-thirds gender rule will bring budget implications. That is, it is an extreme frivolous claim, very vexatious, and meant to mislead these Kenyans and to ensure that this Jubilee government does not implement this constitution as it is.
Currently, four proposed legislations have been published at the National Assembly and one at the Senate. Ndiwa MP Agostino Neto has proposed amendment of the constitution to have two constituencies merged to elect one MP. Narok Women Representative Soipan Tuya proposes an amendment to have two women representatives per county. Kenya Women Parliamentarians Chair Cecily Mbarire is sponsoring the proposal by the technical working group, which seeks to have affirmative action achieved through nominating members of the lesser gender. Justice and Legal Affairs Committee Chair Samuel Chepkonga, however, wants the constitution amended to have the gender rule achieved progressively.
If we allow the amendment of the progressive policy to be put in the constitution,